I'm wasting my way on you. You're just not killing. That's how I'm not going to come on.
I'm getting a lot stack. Not coming through very well. Keep that driving through a tunnel.
Hello?
If you had to say something to Dallas, what would you say? I think you bought it.
That connection from Australia was kind of dicey. Summer, I'm so sorry I interrupted you. You had something to say.
I like paper mache and cross stitch.
Really?
I don't even know what that is.
No.
Fan art. The best fan art I ever got was paper mache, and the other one was a cross stitch Summer, and I really liked
them. Did y'all get your pipe cleaner?
Love my pipe cleaner.
I love my pipe cleaner, Simon.
Lovely.
But there was also, the question also had something to do with fan fiction, right?
Oh, fiction, right?
Yeah. Yeah, which is weird. Because sometimes it can get a little kinky. But it's not just me and you.
What?
Yeah.
Sometimes is it me and Jane, finally?
There is some Simon, Jane, kinky stuff.
With Vera.
Aren't you glad you guys came today? Look at Ron. Ron has no idea what's going on. My favorite is doing panels with Ron. Because you just look over at him and he always has this face.
Looks like it's fun.
Oh my god.
I love the
passion and talent that the fans have whenever they do something fan oriented, just don't send it to my house. There is nothing you can send, do, or say when you send it to my house that doesn't say, I'm crazy and I know where you live. Not cool.
Yeah.
I get a fan letter at my house, I buy a gun.
Do you remember when I gave you a letter at your house and you didn't know it was me?
That was crazy. It was this really weird fan letter that really creeped me out. And then inside is a picture of Jewel laughing, going like this.
And he still has it framed in his house.
Frame that.
Oh, God.
Where's our next question coming from?
Yeah.
Next question. Over here.
Oh, all the way over there.
Where?
Hi. There.
Hello.
Hi.
Way loud. So, on the note of Joss Whedon,
who? I was...
I think we can all agree he's pretty much the most amazing person in the whole world.
Agreed.
Yeah, if you can't tell, I'm dressed like... Anyways, I was wondering what your favorite moment was with Whedon.
Favorite Whedon moment. Go, Adam.
When they rolled on Serenity for the first time, that first scene, I was there with Jane Secular and Joss sitting at Video Village, and he just looked so happy. It was that mixed in with him giving us a tour of the new sets and all that, but that redemption that he had was just such bliss. And I just had to be there. I wasn't even in the scene. I think it was Summer, you were getting tortured or something by some creepy dream sequence. And they were shooting that. But that was, you know, roll one, scene one. And I made sure I was there to try to capture it on film. That's my favorite Joss moment. He was, he just seemed so happy.
Actually, Joss has the distinction of actually having given me one of my happiest moments when he called me and said, Ron, we're making a movie and you're in it. And then,
then came the butt.
With no shame, he said, you die.
That's your favorite?
Gina, favorite Joss moment?
I think it's, he took us to dinner. When we got picked up and told us the story, when we got picked up as a series, and he told us the story that we almost were not picked up as a series. Fox was not sold on the pilot that we shot. They didn't get it. They didn't understand it. They didn't want it. And he and Tim Minear, I think, what, over the course of 2 days, locked themselves up in the house or in the office and came up with a Train Job. And that saved the show. And I thought, I don't know if I've ever met a creative person at that level who cares that much, who is that passionate, and is willing to go that far to see his vision put out there. And look what he created.
Joel.
I'm going to tell a story involving you and tequila.
What do you mean?
Sean and I did this convention last November in the UK.
Oh, that's the story I was going to tell.
Too bad.
a dual answer.
Yeah.
And Joss was in the area and hadn't told anybody, and he sent us an email and said, so I think I'm really close to your hotel. You were staying out at Heathrow, which is near the airport. There's basically nothing there. And he said, let's meet up for a drink after your convention duties are done. So we met him in the lobby bar of the hotel. We had a few drinks.
Just a few.
And Joss says, I feel like going dancing.
To which we said, the only place we could think of to dance would be the convention after party, but there'd be so many fans there, and are you comfortable with that?
And he said, yeah.
Okay.
And then we decided that it would be best to put him in a disguise.
So we.
And the disguise, after a few tequilas, consisted of a
scarf.
Women's scarf tied around his head like a turban.
Which we were like, this is totally gonna work.
We're like, this is it, Joss. No one will know it's you.
No one will know it's you, and then you can go dance and have a great time and not be.
My favorite is that you said, I want a disguise. John puts on his glasses.
Tequila.
I go, who are you, Clark Kent? So we took a cab back to this convention, okay, and walked straight into this disco party. We walked up to the bar and Joss requests Beyonce, single ladies. And we all get out on the dance floor and you can see through the crowd, people start to realize what's going on. It was like a buzz that just happened in the room. And people, scarf. I'm telling you, this says, yeah, the scarf came off. He was like, no one's buying this, you guys. But the most amazing thing about Brown Coats is that everyone was super respectful. They let him have a great time.
But he gave hugs and took pictures.
He gave hugs, but like, we just dance formed a dance circle. Yeah. On the dance floor with us and like, I don't know how many hundreds of brown coats, and just danced for hours till like 4 in the morning.
That's awesome.
And it was so much fun.
So fun. Was anybody there?
Anybody go to that one?
Anyone go to that one?
Look.
Oh.
Wasn't that the best?
Such a good night.
Hi, dancing buddy.
Summer. Wait, give that woman a microphone.
Is that, that's Wendy, right? Yeah.
Give that woman a microphone, please.
It was an absolutely fabulous evening, and Sean and Jewel, thank you for bringing him there. I know everybody just thoroughly loved having him.
Yeah, aww. It was fun.
We had a good time.
I was going to say the time that we went dancing with him in Spain.
That was a good time.
He's a really good dancer. Very surprising.
Really good dancer.
Creative.
Yeah, he's a flailer for sure.
When Joss starts dancing, he doesn't stop. Just keeps dancing. It's like a 4-hour dance marathon. And he's always doing it. My favorite Joss moment was when people come up to you and say, hey, when you choose your roles, or are you going to do more sci-fi, or would you rather do this, or what are you going to do next? That's not how it happens. We don't go, next I think sci-fi. We look for jobs, and when someone gives us one, that's the role we choose. The one they gave us. Thank you. It's very, very hard to work your way up in the system that is the entertainment industry. I used to work a lot. My first job was 3 years working every day on a soap. I had more experience in 3 years than people do in 20. I had a lot of experience behind me. No one cared. That's daytime. It's like I had to start over. That's all right. And when... I gotcha. They called again?
No, they're holding it.
People holding it back.
Guys back there holding it. Thanks.
They've shored it up.
Good on you.
Thank you. Thank
Good time.
When you get a role, they say, oh, he's great. We just don't know if he can handle a lead. Well, no one will give me a lead to show you that I can handle it. Joss Whedon came to me one day and said, I want you to play Malcolm Reynolds. And it changed my career, which changed my life. think we all in this room can say we have a champion in our lives. Someone who gave us an opportunity, someone who helped us, someone who held us up at one point or another. For me, that man is Joss Whedon.
Hello.
Hello.
On those Firefly panels, are there any topics that you wish people would either ask more or less about?
How many times?
I got one. Can y'all stop talking about Zac Efron? I have a funny story, and I'm going to paraphrase a little bit. I was with Amy Acker, who you all, I'm sure, love and know. We were doing a panel together, and a fan stood up and she said, "Hey, you know, my question is for Sean. You know, I just, you know, Zac Efron played the young Simon." And da, da, da. So I was just wondering, how does it feel that his career has totally eclipsed yours? And I turned to Amy like this. To which she said, "Yeah, he just said that." And I was like, "Okay, so I just want to confirm you used the word eclipse." Okay, thanks. And then answer my question. So, no more Zac Efron questions, please.
I never thought I would be sick of any Firefly questions, but there's one that's starting to get to me. Is there going to be more Firefly? Let's pretend for a second that there was. I'm not saying there was. Please don't put this on the internet, for the love of God. And then please don't put this on the internet and say, and then Nathan Lee jokingly said, "Don't put it on the internet." I'm not joking, don't put this on the internet. Let's say there was. Do you think you're gonna find out from me in a restaurant? Don't tell anyone, but. So that one, I'm getting a little like, come on guys. Come on guys.
Yeah.
Who's Zac Efron?
You guys sick of hearing? Want to hear more?
People.
Don't ask me to sing that frickin' song. Not gonna do it. Wouldn't be prudent.
People just want to give me strawberries all the time. I don't like strawberries. I don't like them. Just like I don't know how to fix a spaceship, I don't like strawberries. If you gave me a cheeseburger, that would be a different story.
She loves a burger.
Yeah. And then I feel like I'm letting them down, you know? Because they give me a box of strawberries and I say, "Oh, I don't really like strawberries." And then they have this really devastated look on their face. Sort of like, "Oh." And then I feel really bad. And I don't want to feel bad. That's mine.
Run.
Well, I really do not know Book's backstory. And from the way things look, you're not going to get to know either. Oh, God.
The thing I get asked most is, what is it like to play such strong female characters?
What is it like? Never mind.
Well, it's awesome.
Yeah,
it is. I mean, as you know, it's great. It's great to, you know, kick ass in boots with guns and high heels and tight skirts. And, you know, I mean, it's great. Pass it along. It's great.
Don't forget the leather.
He always has to go there.
I've forgotten the leather.
Leather.
Oh, the leather. Oh, sorry, right. The leather and the rubber and the, yeah. And the oil and the talcum. And who's the best kisser? You know, Alan or Nathan or Marina? Come on. We all know. Okay, next.
Who's the next question? Over here.
If there was a recast, and you get to pick your character's recast other than yourself,
yeah.
Who would you like to see?
Huh.
That's a good question.
Zac Efron.
Michael Rooker.
I'm reminded of a story when Ron Glass went to audition for, they wanted a Ron Glass type, and he didn't get the role.
Tell us about that, Ron.
Ron, who would you have play you other than you?
You.
The special hell. Who's the guy that does those Allstate commercials?
Dennis.
Haysbert, yeah.
Haysbert?
Yeah. I can see him in the book. Joel, who'll play you?
I don't know. I don't want anybody playing her but me.
That's fair.
I just don't. Sorry.
Lawrence Fishburne.
That's gonna be awkward for whoever gets Ellen's part. For whom I'm casting Danny McBride. And for me, I'm gonna go with a Jason Bateman. Or Jason Statham. Summer, who would play you? Amy Acker.
I always wanted Ellen's job, so maybe Ellen could play River.
Weird.
Next, who's got next? Who's got next? We got time for one more.
That went by really fast.
So fast.
The time flew.
Who schedules these things?
I know. We should have done it.
Bring him out here. Yeah,
I got a lot more to say. I got a lot more to share. Time with you guys.
Yeah.
The question is really a thank you. I'm one of the select few, but growing fans, that I learned about you in Afghanistan. Y'all were my shining star. Thank you.
There's a set of Firefly, and there's a DVDs, and there's a Serenity DVD on the International Space Station. Did you know that?
Yeah.
On the space station?
I did not.
There's a picture of them floating in zero G, and the guy behind them going. I love that. Thank you for welcome.
To all the men and women, the United States military, thank you for your service. Thank you for keeping us free. And God bless the families of those who serve for your sacrifice. Because we know how hard it is when your loved ones go away and put their lives on the line to let us do this for our family. So God bless you all. Thank you, Dallas.
In closing, Ron, what? Ron, in closing, do you have anything you'd like to say to everybody in closing?
I'm really looking forward to next time. Thank you all for being here. And everybody on the stage, thank you all for being here. I don't see you guys enough. And this has really been great. Really, really, really been great. So they say that everything's bigger in Texas, right? This has been huge! Thank you!
Do you have any words?
I love you. And I love all of you a lot.
I was just gonna say the same thing. I love y'all, something fierce. And I love each and every one of these people up here on this stage right now. And so it's true.
The plural of y'all is all y'all.
Let me try that again. I love all y'all, something fierce.
This is the last chance we'll have to address everybody, ensemble.
I'm proud to be home. Thanks, guys.
Yeah. I love seeing y'all. You honor me by your presence here. You honor me with keeping this ball going. You bless me by giving me the opportunity to be reunited with all these incredible people that I love and I miss. So good to see you. Thank you. And thank you.
Adam?
I would just echo that. I am so proud to be a part of this cast. It's one of the most beautiful casts and heartwarming group of people I've ever had the pleasure of knowing, and to be here and have you a part of this and to share this is what, to me, when Firefly comes to my mind, all I think of is love, because that's what keeps this thing going, and Nathan's hair. Nathan?
To all you guys out there who have a very special place in your heart for Firefly, I get it. I love it. And I am blessed. I love you all. I love you all more altogether. You guys are a big deal to me. Thank you very much. Thank you.